Champa was a little adorable girl who lived in Vijayanagar with her parents. And her best friend was her mouse Minnie, with whom she used to play all day long.
All right, Minnie, don't come out. I brought rice for you.
Champa!
Hide, Minnie, hide!
Champa! Are you done feeding him? Oh, will you keep feeding him? Or will you make some arrangements for eating at home too? Go and bring some dry wood. Only then will the food be cooked.
I will just go and come back. And yes, Minnie and I will eat kheer today.
Huh?
After a while, Champa got tired of searching for wood in the jungle, but couldn't find any dry wood anywhere.
From where should I get dry wood?
Champa was so tired that as soon as she sat down, she dozed off. And what happened to her afterwards, she could have never imagined.
Champa? Champa? I am talking to you.
But how can you talk?
Because you can hear me. If I were dry, I could happen to help you. But all around me are these large leafy bushes and not a single ray of sun reaches me. What shall I do? How do I stay dry? No one even cut these bushes.
Don't look at me. It's not my fault. See? I am wet myself because the sun's rays don't reach me as well.
What? The leaf is also speaking?
Yes, because you are listening. That means I am speaking. And yes, the mistake is the sun's, not mine.
What should I do? I want to give light to everyone, but these dark clouds always cover me.
Don't blame me. I'll show you the right way. Did you see it? This wind won't let me go anywhere else.
Now, what should I do? Are you seeing that tall palace in front of me? Its gate is always closed. Then tell me, how can I go beyond it?
After listening to everyone, Champa felt that all the trouble was because of the palace gate. That's why she went straight to the palace to meet the queen.
So you want to know why I keep the gate closed? Are you looking at that parrot? It tells me such wonderful stories that I don't want any disturbance due to the open gate.
So you are the root cause of all the problems.
No. I have also come here running from my problems. The owner of the pond in the jungle kept threatening to drown my nest in the water repeatedly.
Wherever Champa went, she learned about a new problem. But she decided that she would solve everyone's problems, even if she had to go into the jungle. And with this determination, she reached the location shared by the parrot.
So the parrot used to live here, and all the problems started from this pond. Who are you?
The owner of this pond. And my intention was absolutely not to drive away the parrot. The elephant comes here and threatens me every day that he would drink all the water from the pond. So, I vented my anger on the poor parrot.
You should learn to control your anger. You have no idea what problems have arisen due to your anger. Everyone is troubled.
Tell me, should I bite you? Tell me, tell me.
I will get rid of you today at any cost.
Wait! If you drink all the water from this pond, what will the other animals drink?
So what should I do? This snake sits on my tail and threatens to bite me. I just want to throw the snake off by pouring the entire pond water on myself. Because my trunk can't reach my tail.
Elephant King, today I'll tell you the truth. I sit on your tail not to bite you, but to protect myself from that potter in the village. I just go to his house to eat the mouse there. But as soon as he sees me, he starts running behind me to beat me.
Champa was unsure about what to do in this situation.
Everyone has their own problem. I don't know who's telling the truth and who's lying.
Therefore, to find out the truth, she went to the potter's house.
That snake is troubling me too much. Whenever he comes, he breaks up pots. No matter how hard I try, he escapes every time. But the day I catch him, it will be his last day.
Why are you laughing?
What should I do if not laugh? What a foolish person he is. He doesn't even know that the snake comes here not to break his pots, but to eat me.
What do you mean?
I come here in search of food, just for 4 grains of rice. And I also get to stay in the pots made by him.
What? My entire journey led me to a little mouse? Do you have any idea how big a problem you have created in the pursuit of 4 grains of rice?
How do I know?
All right. What if I give you those 4 grains of rice?
Then why would I come here? Tell me.
All right, my friend. My friend Minnie will bring you the grains. And when they are finished, I will send for more. But do not come here again, okay?
Champa started sending grains for the mouse. And everything was resolved. With the mouse gone, the snake also stopped coming there. Delighted by the departure of the snake, the elephant also promised not to trouble the owner of the pond anymore. Champa conveyed this news to the parrot, and the parrot returned to his home. As soon as the parrot left, the queen opened the door of her room, allowing the air to flow through the door. After that, the owner of the pond never troubled the parrot. And the clouds also moved away from the sun. Now the sun rays fell directly on the bushes, causing them to dry quickly. And the wet wood placed there also dried.
Champa, are you sleeping? Wake up, wake up. Oh, I told you to bring wood. Have you started dreaming after collecting the wood?
Dream? I don't know if it was a dream or reality. But Mother, 4 grains of rice can change the world.
What do you mean?
Nothing, Mother. You just keep giving me a little rice every week.
Champa's mother had no idea what Champa was trying to convey. But a mother is ultimately a mother. Without asking any questions, she gave Champa a handful of rice and Champa. Rajkumari Padma, the daughter of King Vidyadhar of Vijayanagar, had grown into a beautiful woman. And tales of her beauty had spread far and wide. Many princes from different kingdoms were eager to marry her, But whenever the topic of marriage came up, Princess Padma would refuse. There was an unusual story behind her reluctance.
Princess, many proposals for your marriage have come, but you don't like any of the boys.
Father, I trust no man other than you, so I will not marry anyone.
But how will you spend your life alone, Princess? I request you to choose a good boy and marry him.
The princess' trust in boys had faded. But this news had spread not only in Vijayanagar, but also in the neighboring kingdoms. One day, Rajkumar Venkat of the neighboring kingdom Uttamnagar got to know about this. After learning everything, he decided to meet the princess and reached Vijayanagar in disguise.
I've heard that the princess doesn't like boys, but there must be a reason behind it. First, I need to find out the cause. But whom should I ask? Whom should I ask?
Spare me this time, Munna. I won't put so much burden on you next time. Save me!
Listen, brother.
Yes, tell me.
Stay happy, dear. There was no need to bow down so hard. You seem to be a nice boy. I should leave, or else I'll be late in reaching the palace.
The palace? Whatever happened, happened for good. Let me ask her. Auntie! Oh, auntie! Auntie, I will pick it up.
God bless you, dear.
Thank you, auntie. Do you work in the palace?
Yes, dear.
Oh, then you must know Princess Padma as well.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Since her childhood.
Auntie, if you don't mind, may I ask you something?
Yes, go ahead.
Then tell me, why does Princess Padma dislike boys?
What should I say, dear? It's a very long story.
The palace is far too. We can cover the story while walking to the palace.
All right, let me tell you. The princess had a strong bond with the maid since childhood. And the maid took care of her from the beginning. During that time, she used to tell the princess the same story every day. The story was about a beautiful Maina family with a Maina, her husband and two children. Everyone lived happily in their nest. But one day, a fire broke out in the tree. The poor Maina kept pleading with her husband to take them and the children somewhere safe. But he kept thinking that the fire would extinguish soon. But in no time, the tree along with the Maina and her children caught fire. And the husband left them flying away.
What the Maina's husband did was absolutely wrong.
This is exactly what the princess also feels. Due to repeatedly hearing the same story, she became so influenced by it that gradually she started to believe that this life of hers is the second life of that Maina. In her past life, her husband had done something so terrible to her, and that's why she dislikes every boy.
So that's the matter. Auntie, we have reached the palace. Thank you for sharing the story.
God bless you, dear.
So this is the reason for the princess's dislike towards boys. I'll have to think of a solution so that Princess Padma's dislike ends forever. My king, I'm a storyteller. I have tales of every taste, old and new, from every place, near and far. If you permit, I would like to narrate them to you.
Yes, of course, why not? You have my permission.
But my king, I have one condition.
What condition?
I will not talk to any woman. And I will not narrate my stories to any woman.
What kind of condition is this? May I know the reason behind it?
Certainly, my king. When I was traveling for stories across different places, I met a sage. Pleased with my services, he told me that in my past life, I was a male miner. I used to live in a tree with my wife and children. One day, a fire broke out in that tree and my wife left, leaving us to burn. I kept pleading with her to save all of us, but she didn't listen and left, saving only herself. After knowing that, I developed a dislike towards women. I decided that I would never get married.
Stop it! How dare you steal my story? You are not a storyteller, but a thief! Soldiers, arrest him! My king, he is lying. This is not his, but my story. And he was the one who left us. I am the same Maina who was your wife in the past life.
No, my king. My story is absolutely true. She is the one lying.
No, you are lying.
Princess Padma and Prince Venkat were not ready to end their argument. Both considered their stories to be true. Seeing this, King Vidyadhar thought of something to stop their fight.
Stop! This is my court, and no one can violate its decorum. For this, both of you can be punished.
Forgive me, my king.
Forgive me, my king. But what kind of justice is this in your kingdom? I only set a condition that I would not narrate my story to any woman. But no one respected my condition, and in return, I have been arrested too. Well, now that I have been made a prisoner, at least tell me your decision. According to you, whose story is true? Mine or Princess Padma's?
It seems like you have a lot of knowledge about justice and rights. You are not an ordinary young man. Quickly reveal your true identity. This is an order from the king. Prince Venkat, is it you? My king, my king. He's Prince Venkat from our neighborhood kingdom, Uttamnagar. Very wise and brave.
Oh, so that's the case. Well, now I will announce my decision. Princess Padma thinks that in her past life, her husband, the male Maina, betrayed her. Whereas, according to the story of Prince Venkat, the betrayal was done by his wife, the female man. But regardless of whose mistake it was, both of you know that it was a mistake. And in this life, both of you are aware of it.
Yes, my king.
I believe that it doesn't matter what you were or what mistakes you made in your past life. What matters is what you should do in this life. Both of you have the opportunity to rectify the mistakes of your past life in this life if you wish to.
But how, my king?
Both of you get married. And then, together, you can move forward without repeating those mistakes.
Padma and Venkat understood the king's words. And they got married. And started living together.
If you like this video, subscribe to our channel, Murthy Media.